Welcome back, students. Hopefully you're doing well. First of all, I would like to thank you that you guys gave me very positive response on my previous lecture, which was spherical mirror equation. And today we are going to crack down another amazing equation for the lens, which is almost similar to the spherical mirror equation. Okay, student, here we will take a convex lens and we'll place an object on the left side of this convex lens. The question is, if I place an object here, where I will get the image? How far this image will be from the optical center? Is it clear? So one method is by using ray diagram method, we can easily identify that this image is that much far away from the optical center. But do you think this method is convenient? No, this method is not convenient because it is time taking process. That's why we are looking for an equation by which we can easily identify that how far this image will be from the optical center and how much this image is magnified as compared to object. Okay, is it clear? Done. Okay, student, let's see how this ray diagram works, then we will move towards the equation. Okay, here you can see that in my previous lecture I told you, if any light ray like this one, which is parallel to the principal axis, this is the principal axis and this is the light ray which is parallel to the principal axis, it always converges at a point which we call it principal focus. Is it clear? No matter how many light rays are coming, if those light rays are parallel to the principal axis, it always converges at a point F which we call principal focus. Then, student, okay. Secondly, student, if any light ray we strike at the point of optic center, it neither diverges nor converges. Then, student, it just follows its path here like this, and the point where these two light rays intersect each other, that is the point where we can easily identify that how much image is far away from the optical center. So we just simply draw a vertical line and here we will get the image. Simple. Done, student? Okay. So now how we can easily derive the equation. So it's very simple. First, I hopefully you know the concept of ratio. In ratio, we just simply divide similar quantities. Here we also need a similar triangles. By identifying these triangles, we can easily derive the equation. Okay, let's see which triangles are similar. So here you can see that this triangle, give it the name OBAO. This triangle here, this is the angle theta. This triangle is similar to CDO. This triangle is similar to this one because their angles are equal. These angles are equal. So if their angles are equal, so we can say that these triangles are similar. And if they are similar, we can easily apply the ratio formula. Is it clear, student? Okay. For your better understanding, I'm just removing this line, this light ray. Okay. So you can easily identify that this and this triangle is similar. Done, student? Okay. Now, if these triangles are similar, we can divide their sides. But the point is which side? Okay. So we are interested in two things. One is magnification and second one is how far the image is from the optic center. It means we are not interested in hypotenuse. We are interested in the base side of this triangle and this vertical, this perpendicular side of the triangle. We are not interested in the hypotenuse. Is it clear? So we will take the ratio of perpendicular with perpendicular and the base of this triangle with this base of this triangle. Is it clear? Then okay, let's start. So here we can say that HO, object height, divided by ratio image height. Is it clear? And in our case the image is inverted, so we'll place an minus sign here. Okay, then student, okay, equal. Now we are interested in how far the image is, so the ratio of this triangle base with this one. Okay, so this is AO and this AO is equal to DO, distance of object from center of the optic center. Is it clear? So we just simply, there is no need to first write AO, you can write it DO, divide by, student, this one, the base of this triangle, which is OC or CO, it's equal to DI. Is it clear, student? So we'll put DI. Do you think this is enough from this we can derive an equation. No, this is not enough, because in numeric student, in a numerical, they will give us h, the height of the object, the distance of object from the optical center, but still we have these two things are missing. So how it is possible that if these two things are missing, or we can how we will identify that how much the image is magnify, or how much the image is far away from the optical center? That's why we need another triangle, some more triangles by which we can easily manipulate this equation, and we will drive the main equation. Done, student? Okay. So now this light ray which was going like this. Okay. So here we will take these two triangles, students. First one is this one, like that, this one, this one. Okay, student, like this, this triangle. And second one is this one. I'm removing this for your better understanding. These, there we have two triangles. First one is this, that's one, and second one is this. By using these triangles, these are again similar, because this theta angle is equal to this theta angle. So these are also similar triangles. Okay, then again we are interested in their magnification height and how far the image is. So students, here again you see this height, this O, or whatever you can give it, E, okay, name, this OE is equal to AB, and AB is equal to HO. So we just simply write HO, okay? Then student, okay, and divided by this, which is CD, and CD is equal to HI. HI ratios are similar, because triangles are similar, so we can divide their side. Okay, okay, now we are not interested in hypotenuse. We will use the base. Base is OF, and OF is equal to, student, CF. So here we will just simply write F. Okay, now this is little bit tricky, this part, not that much simple. Okay, see, students, here we are interested in the base of this triangle. Okay, and from this point to this point, from D to O, the distance is DI. We can write it DI, but in this case, now right now the base of the triangle is from this point to this point. Okay, so what we will do, how we will get this base? See, if I minus this part F from this hole, so we will get the remaining portion is equal to FC. Agree? So we just simply, what we do, from this DI, this whole part will just minus F. If we minus this F, the remaining portion will be equal to the base of this triangle. Agree, student? Okay. So we'll write here DI minus F. Done, student? And again the image is inverted, so we'll put our negative sign here and just name it equation number 1, equation number 2. Now we can easily compare these two equations. Why? Because they are, I mean, this is similar, so we can easily compare these two equations. Okay, by comparing, just right here, I have not that much space, right here comparing equation 1 and 2. Okay, we'll compare it. So simply DO divided by DI equal F divided by DI minus F. There are many methods that from which you can easily derive the equation. It's depends upon you. You can take reciprocal and then do it simply mathematics, whatever you want. Okay, what I will do, I'll just simply cross multiply first of all here. So this portion will be multiplied with that one, with this one. So, and this portion will be multiplied with this one. Agree, student? Easy. Okay, now what we'll do, the main equation is, student, 1 divided by F equal 1 divided by DI plus 1 divided by DO. This is the main equation, and we have we will drive this, okay, from this one. Okay, now just simply multiply this with these two terms. So we will write DO DI minus DO F equal DI F. Done, student? Okay, now further what we can do, student, here we can easily like this F here, it is multiplying on the when we'll take it to the this side, it will divide. Okay, agree? Multiply, if we'll take it to this side, it will divide. So simply I will write here DO DI minus DO into F divided by F equal DI. Student, we can also write it individually like that one, DO di divided by f minus do f divided by f equal di. Agree, students? Okay. Here, this is simple math. I'm doing simple maths here, so it's not rocket science. Okay, student? Hopefully, you are understanding it. Like, if I take, like, student, 9x plus 8x, 8y divided by 4. So, we can also write it like that one, 9x divided by 4 plus 8y divided by 4. We know that. Okay, because after taking LCM, again, we will... As a result, if you take LCM, we will get this one. Agree, student? Okay. So, same here, I just separate it individually. Okay, in denominators. Okay. Now, this f, we can easily cancel out with this f. Okay. And what's, we get the remaining portion. Do, ti, 1 by f, here, minus do, equal di. Student, this term is here. If I take this term to the right side, it will plus, okay, so we'll take here do. Done. Okay, this term is multiplying with 1. If I take to the take this term to the right term, to the right side, so it will divide on the both side on this with these two terms. Agree students? Okay, so here, see guys, 1 by f equal di divided by d naught di plus to divided by to di. Here these two terms are divide, these terms are divide, and finally we will get 1 by f equal 1 by do plus 1 by di. This is our full and final equation. Hopefully guys, you understand it, and it's easy method, not that much complex, just need a little bit focus and you can easily understand it. That's right. Okay. Now, the second thing is, from this we can easily identify how far the image is from the optical center. Done, student? Okay. Now, student, we are also interested to derive the formula for the magnification, and magnification is the ratio of height of image to the height of object. So, magnification is the ratio of height of image to the height of object. Done, student? Okay. And we will write here a negative sign because our image is inverted. That's right. Okay. Now, guys, see this formula is similar to this one. I mean, this is the reciprocal of this one. Okay. So, if we just change the denominator into the numerator and numerator into the denominator. That's right. So, because of this, we can also write that hi is equal to di and ho is equal to do. Then, student, because of this equation number 1, you can say that, okay? Okay. Here, this negative sign is multiplying with hi. We just simply multiply both sides with negative sign. After multiplying these two sides with negative, so we'll get this negative with negative, it will become positive. Hi divided by ho equal minus di divided by to. So, this is our full and final formula for the magnification. Keep in mind, while using these formulas, as this formula is valid for the convex lens, like this one, this is the valid for the convex lens. But when we are using concave lens, we have to follow some convention. And I will upload and I will make a video on the convention in the next lecture. Hopefully, guys, you understand all of these things. Still, if you have any query, any question, you can ask me in a comment section. #peaceout. Milte hain next video mein. Allah Hafiz.